Okay, good morning to all of you, right? So we've completed the previous chapter, which was measures of central tendency, and today we will be starting with a new unit, which is measures of dispersion. I'm Suparna Saha. I teach economics in class 11th and 12th. I've been teaching for the past 18 years. Since March 26, 2020, we've shifted from offline classes to online classes, and that has radically changed the way that we teach today.
Technology, the once known as an aid, is now the medium.
Well, it has not totally turned everything upside down. I mean, teaching in person in classroom and teaching online are totally different, different things.
When it comes to the challenges, I have a long list to share the challenges for online mode of teaching. Familiarity with the new platform that the school had chosen was one of them.
Frankly speaking, teachers as a community are not very technologically aware, because offline medium does not require you to be well versed with it.
To adapt to this has been very difficult for me. Shifting to teaching through online modes of communication was never even heard of. And I think the tools for the same were also very, very limited.
Initially, when there were no maids, no one to work, we were working, doing double time, triple time. We were doing the housework and then taking online classes. So it was a big, it is a big challenge teaching online.
I wake up at 4 a.m. in the morning and immediately I get into the kitchen. I first make tea and then I have to start preparing breakfast. Once breakfast is done, I have to also do some preparations towards lunch, because I don't know when my classes, even if my classes get over, when I'll be free from schoolwork. After that is done, I do my yoga and then go for a bath. By the time I'm done with all that, I just have enough time to have a quick breakfast and then sit down for my classes, which begin at 8 o'clock. Classes officially go on till 1, some days 1:30, but very often it is followed by other schoolwork, such as making of papers, preparing for next day's class, or preparing PPTs for the classes, corrections, attendance, and lots of other things.
It further included poor internet, lack of uninterrupted power supply, and when it comes to teaching learning, there were clear hindrances to motivate the students. I longed to replicate the rapport I had with my students in face-to-face teaching.
Now the challenge is to get the students to talk. They all switch off their videos and audios and are mute spectators, if at all they are there at the other end. Sometimes I really wonder, are they there, or have they just logged in and they've gone to sleep or gone off somewhere? Because neither is their video on nor is their audio on. And even if you call out to them, many a times they don't respond. So we don't even know whether we're getting through to them.
We read in the newspapers that, students are harassing the teachers and they are playing pranks or they are doing things which is not very comfortable for the teacher. But we never think that it's going to happen to us at any point of time. We feel that our students are different.
One of the incidents that really shook me was when a student was able to take control of the presentation mode within the app and started showing porn. So the teacher concerned was extremely flustered and he immediately tried to switch it off, but what was shown on the screen was probably carved into his mind, because he was very scared. It was a male teacher. He was very scared to actually deal with that class again. I don't think students are malicious. They just do it for fun. They want to see whether they can rattle the teacher or not. So it is entirely up to the teacher to ensure that they know a little bit more about the using the app than the student, which I think after 8 months we all have.
Online mode of teaching can never substitute what classroom teaching do or teach to a student. When students interact with each other in a class, in a normal classroom scenario, then their personalities are developed much better than what online classes can do.
This pandemic has made it very clear, not even locally but globally, that a teacher cannot be replaced. Technology can be a medium, an aid, but not the teacher.
Although after 8 months, we as a teaching community are very confident, quite confident, even if I don't say very, we are quite confident about teaching online. Yet, if I am true to myself, I will say that online teaching is no substitute for offline teaching. Because no matter how much we prepare for online teaching through PPTs, through videos, it will never be the same, because unless you have contact with the children also lose contact with you. They are not connected to you, and unless they are connected to you, they don't find the inspiration to do well, or they don't get that impetus in them to push them forward and make them do better. Thank you for asking for my views about this, but I hope we will not be doing this very long, and I hope everything gets better soon. Thanks.